A proud woman in the Bronx becomes a mentor to thousands of children in the city and a model for making a difference. As we continue our series honoring Black History Month, tonight, CBS 2's Jessica Layton introduces us to the new leader of the nation's first and the city's largest youth mentoring program.
I am the CEO of Big Brothers Big Sisters of New York City.
And how does it feel to say that?
Amazing. Amazing. And deeply humbling.
It would be an honor for anyone, but Alicia Guevara is the first female CEO in the 117-year history of Big Brothers Big Sisters New York City.
I come to it with the fullness of my experience as a woman and as a woman of color. I am a Black woman. I am a Latina.
And a proud one at that. Born and raised in the Bronx, she's built a career believing in the power of mentorship, probably because of the indelible mark made by her first mentor, her mom.
She just believed in me. And having someone tell you that they believe in you when you're 7, 8 years old is invaluable. And so when I look at our young people, no matter what their age, no matter what their stage, I say, I believe in you.
She has a kindness, a compassion that's evident immediately, no doubt stemming from the values taught and the love felt in that old neighborhood on Marion Avenue.
Our household was the household that took in all of the kids in our community. It's where you could always come to get a plate of rice or a cup of sugar.
What is it like raising your kids in the same borough where you were born?
They get to actually see and experience where I lived and appreciate all of the lessons that my community taught me.
The wife and mother of two now dedicates the same open door and open heart she knew as a child to the 5,300 young people her nonprofit is helping every day. One of her many mantras, the mentors are there to complement the parents, not replace them.
That belief, that trust that you could do anything, is there enough of that right now in New York City, particularly in our communities of color?
I think we could be doing more. I think now is the time to double down and invest in the very potential that's there. Oftentimes we talk about building potential. Well, the potential is there.
It's evident in 14-year-old Gianna of Brooklyn, who shared with us what Black History Month means to her.
It's really special by seeing like people that look like yourself and seeing the amount of love that they get and the amount of things that they've accomplished.
The culture and history of the Black community is something she and her mentor Paige talk about often when visiting museums and trying out new restaurants. But the pandemic kept them physically apart for a long time.
Really, it was almost a year.
In fact, less than a year into her position as CEO, Guevara found herself guiding the group of thousands through this crisis. In a time these already vulnerable kids were uprooted from their friends and their schools, it meant careful training for the mentors so they could best help their littles.
How to have difficult conversations, compassionate conversations, in the face of multiple pandemics, a health pandemic, a pandemic that's also plagued by racial inequities. I think our littles learned that they were not alone. Now is the moment for them to amplify their voices.
And even in the current virtual environment, her goal day in and day out, help pave the way for them to do that.
It's been made clear to me that representation matters. My duty in those spaces is to continue to open up doors so that others can come after me.
A girl from the Bronx, now a woman in charge, giving back in such a big way to the borough that believed in her. Jessica Layton, CBS 2 News.